I met Bishop about when I was 16 and a half years old. I was already saved and doing a little ministry, but I was impressed with him the day he came to Tuscumbia, Alabama. That's where I was raised up at. And when I met him, he preached a message that stirred my heart, the message of the Master is calling. At that time I met him, he came down to guide one of his ministers that he had sent down to do some work in the South. He told him that he should not get involved too many churches that, you know, they're going to fight against him. But then he came down to rescue him, I guess you would use the word. And from that time, he came by and he talked to him. He got the teaching that he taught. I was impressed with it because I never heard a man talk like that. He was telling them, he was allowing the church to know that they were not able to do anything for him, but he's going to be there to help the church. He said, I'm going to take over the church and I'm going to pass it, whatever along those lines. And I was very impressed because he said, now you can't help me. You don't have enough money to help me, so I'm going to help you. And I was impressed with that. From 16 and a half years old, I went, left out with him. After a while, we left out together and did a little evangelistic work. The first revival I ran, that he took me out on the road to train me, was in Ralph, Alabama. And as I ran the revival, we got $14.25 for the week revival. And on our way back, we was on our way to Michigan, and we had a blowout. And the blowout cost $14.25. And everywhere you will see Bishop, you will see me. I will be with him just about everywhere you go. And I raised up with him. He reeled me up, not raised up with him, but he reeled me. And I looked up to him as my father. We slept together on benches. We slept, amen, in the church trying to do some things, amen, for the Lord. Amen. After a while, I was separated from him for a little while because of a calling to the service. And when I was called in the service, he had trained me before I went in the service how to put up a tent for revival and stuff like this. And so I would do the tent work and whatever along the land I was preaching, you know, but I was called on the service. And after I come out, we joined back up together again. And I just, you know, I just love, you know, Bishop Ever because he had taught me so many things.
So when you joined the service, when you were called up to the service, right. Which war was that? That was World War II, correct?
No, that was
Vietnam War. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so as I came out of the service, you know, we stood together, do many things, you know, many problems began to hit the church. Let me just put it like that. Many problems get to hit the church, but we stood together.
Praise God. We want to hear this. Thank the Lord for what he has done for us. I really enjoyed myself on today.
Yes.
Amen. I just thank the Lord for being sent here by my Father.
All right.
Amen. A lot of times, amen, I can't say younger days, but in my days, it taught me a lot of things.
All right.
And I was thinking about my son when he come up. You said a lot of things about him, amen, because of things that I have said about him.
That's right.
I mean, those are part of that. He's got some experience on his own, but right. Those are some of the parts that I said.
Amen.
Amen. Sometimes when I have problems, you know, you have problems with the deacon board or whatever along those lines. Sometimes I have to pay the way. Amen. I say, amen, I don't have no problem because I know that man don't pay. You don't take it from me? Amen. I pay your way to go up there and get it from him. Go up there and get it. Amen. I'll be the case. I don't even have to be in the meeting or anything.
All
just
right.
Go up there and talk to him. And he going to tell you the same thing.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
All
right. I appreciate it. Amen.
All right.
Of Bishop Evans because all the time I know him. And amen. Just like my son said. Amen. A lot of times you say things you like may not be. But it's the truth. It's what you need to hear. always been consistent. You know, it's not that he's going to say something today and going to change tomorrow. Amen. Whatever he was born or whatever he believed when he came in, that's what he believed.